The story I wanted to tell today is, well, maybe I'll introduce myself a little bit. So I'll say my name and who I am in my language, and then I'll tell you what that means, and then we'll get into the fun that we're going to have here. So Cheryl L’Hirondelle and the Tsigaswan, Api Tokasan Squeo Omania, nêhiyawin Squeo, Alberta, amiskwaciy wâskahikan, ē-kwēkimot, ohci, maga Saskatoon migwatsnewegan. So I said in my language, which is Cree, I told you that my name, it's Cheryl L’Hirondelle, and I told you that I'm a half-breed. Now, I know some people say Métis, but I say half-breed, and there's a good long story that I won't go into today about why I say it that way. And then I told you that I'm from Northern Alberta, but I live now in Saskatoon. So the story I want to tell, though, is if you read these instructions, it's telling you that you actually can roll on this hide. So not a lot of artwork in a lot of galleries are you allowed to touch, right? You know? But first I want to tell you the story. So in all Indigenous worldviews, we have a trickster being. And that trickster being is responsible for the creation of things. And in our trickster is this very mischievous being. And our trickster is actually a they. Our trickster is neither he nor she, neither spirit nor human or physical world. They are our elder sibling, and they travel around and are always getting into mischief. They're always really curious about, why does that happen that way? And could things happen this way? And there's just so many stories that could be told. And we also don't say the name of our trickster when there's no snow on the ground. So today I'm going to use ksdisano, meaning elder sibling, or I'm going to say nêmoyakagiwihit, which is the name that can't be said. So the reason we don't say the name of our trickster when there's no snow on the ground is that all the plants and all the animals have work to do, and humans, we all have work to do. And so if we say the name of that trickster being, we'll all be going, oh, what are they up to now? Oh, I want to know what they're up to. So we don't say the name. We say nêmoyakagiwihit. So now the story. Kayas Manakayas, a long, long time ago, nêmoyakagiwihit was wandering, and they were, you know, looking around, and they're always saying hello to all their relatives. Tanse, hello, niwakamaganak, hello, hello, nice to see you, tanse. Well, all of a sudden they saw from a distance, they saw Pasqua Mostosak, the buffalo, and they were like, oh, I wonder what it would be like to be a buffalo. Oh, I can just imagine. They're so powerful and they're so majestic. And when they run on the Great Plains, it's thundering. It's the sound of thundering hoofs on the Great Plains. I bet you it would be amazing to be a buffalo. So nêmoyakagiwihit walks up to the head of the buffalo and says, I've always wanted to be you. Can I be you? And the elder buffalo said, let me bring a council together and we'll talk about it. So they brought together all the chief buffaloes and they all talked about it. And they said, well, you know, they're kind of a bit of a character. They're kind of mischievous. I don't know. Do you think we should let them be a buffalo? Do you think they'd be a good buffalo? And they talked about it for a while. And then they said, well, we know that's our elder sibling and let's let them experience it, you know? So they say to nêmoyakagiwihit, they said, yes, we have decided you can become one of us. But what you need to do to become one of us is you need to roll. You need to roll four times. And if you roll four times, you will turn into a buffalo. And so nêmoyakagiwihit was all like, oh, good, how exciting. And they said, but just as a cautionary, if you don't want to turn into one of us and you roll three times, just stop there. Because three times means you're only having fun. And you really don't want to make this transformation. And so nêmoyakagiwihit says, no, I'm into it. Let's do it. And so they rolled once, and then they rolled twice, and then they rolled the third time, and then they rolled the fourth time. And pretty soon, all of a sudden, they were a buffalo. Now, all the buffalo were kind of like looking at nêmoyakagiwihit, and they were trying to hold back their laughter, you know? Because nêmoyakagiwihit hadn't eaten as much grass as they've eaten. And looked a little bit scrawny, you know, like looked a little pitiful, eh? And they were like, don't laugh, just looking a little pitiful. So nêmoyakagiwihit says, okay, now what do I do? how do I eat? What do I eat? And they said, just watch what we do. Eat what we eat. Now, there's not many rules, but here's one. Stay close to us. Don't wander off. Stay with the pack. And when you've ever seen buffalo, what are they usually doing? They're usually in a pack, you know? Well, ē-kwēkimot, he says, well, I'm adventuresome. I'm a buffalo now. So I was eating grass, and at first it was kind of like, ugh, grass, this is really kind of, ugh, you know? But after a while, they really got into it, and they're like, wow, I can really chew a lot of this, and wow, this is great, I can just keep grazing. And they could feel themselves starting to plump out a little bit, eh? But they looked off in the distance, and they saw this beautiful vista, this beautiful hill and sky, and they went, oh, I don't know why the buffalo aren't going over there. I think I'll go over there. So they strayed from the buffalo, and pretty soon they were over a hill, and they were in a little valley all unto themselves. And all of a sudden they heard this noise. They started to hear the sound of like hoofs, and it wasn't buffalo hoofs. And they started to hear the sound of people's voices, and they started to hear like, they started to hear these sounds, and they were like, wonder what's going on. And they saw, coming over the hill, they saw a bunch of Crees. In our language, we say nêhiyawin. And they saw these Crees coming over the hill, and they were on horses, and they had arrows. And ē-kwēkimot, he says, wow, I wonder who they're chasing. I wonder what they're trying to get. And then he realized there was no one around, and it was, they were trying to get them. And so they're like, all right, I'm a buffalo. And so they started running and running and running and running and running and running. And they ran as fast as they could, and they outran them. And they saw the buffalo that they were supposed to be with, and they got close to them, and they just fell over. Oh my gosh, I almost got eaten. I almost got hunted down. And there was one little arrow that was shot, and it went right through the beard. If you've ever seen a buffalo, they have a little beard, kind of like this gentleman has a beard. And there was an arrow going right through the beard, and they were like, phew, they didn't get me. And so the buffalo said, we told you, stay close to us. Don't go off by yourself. So they were chewing grass and chewing more grass and chewing more grass. And then pretty soon they look over there, and they're like, wow, that looks good over there. Kind of like when you're in a gallery and there's beautiful things to look at, you know? Yeah, I'm just going to go over that way. And so soon they're like, okay, I'm getting away from the pack, but I think I'm okay. I'm a buffalo. And all of a sudden they're into another little valley, and there's this wolf. And this wolf is one, and then all of a sudden there's two, and then all of a sudden there's three, and then all of a sudden there's four. And ē-kwēkimot, he says, I wonder who they're looking at. Wow, they're really eyeing up someone, like they want to eat someone. And all of a sudden, ē-kwēkimot says, oh my gosh, that's me. Because if you think of it, one buffalo on their own who kind of looks scrawny to some wolves, that's going to be dinner. Because if it was a pack, they wouldn't have a chance. But if it's one, oh, they might have a chance with one scrawny looking buffalo. So all of a sudden, ē-kwēkimot starts running and running and running and running as fast as they can run, and they outrun those wolves. They get back with the buffalo, flop over on the ground again, tongue hanging out. Oh, and the buffalo said, we told you, stay with us, don't run away. You know, you need to stick with us. That's where our strength is, when we stay together. And so ē-kwēkimot keeps chewing grass and eating grass. And after a little while, he says, you know, this has been fun, but I really like being who I am. And I want to turn back into myself so I can go off in another direction and continue on with my adventures. And so they say, okay, well, you have to roll backwards now four times and you'll turn back into yourself. And so they roll once, twice, three times, four times, and once again, they're ē-kwēkimot. But if you think of it, what the story teaches us is it teaches us that transformation is possible, you know? It teaches us a lot of other things. We won't go into a Q&A, but if you think of it, you know, stay with your beings, don't run off, you could get lost, you could come into danger, but transformation is possible. And so this piece, when you read these instructions for the kids and for the kids in all of us, you know, it's teaching us that there are animal spirits that are good animal spirits that we should try to be like, you know? It might not be a buffalo, might be a bear, might be a horse, runs fast, you know? Might be your favorite cat who you just love hanging out with, right? So what I'd love to invite you to do is I'd love to invite you to become, to roll four times. And then for the kids, if you do roll four times, if you want to roll backwards, you can roll backwards and go back into yourself. Now, this work is going to be here until March. So anytime you need to come and have a transformation, please come back to the gallery and help yourself and have a transformation.